No?
No.
No. Great. Hey guys, this is my best friend Renata.
Hi.
And I'm Izzy, if you don't know me. And so I have Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome. I was just like petting your foot. It was so weird. Okay, so I have hypermobile Ehlers-Danlos Syndrome, and we thought it'd be a good idea for us to go through the criteria because there is not yet a gene that's known to cause hypermobile EDS, and we're just gonna run through the criteria for both of us, and you can see the difference between somebody who does have EDS and somebody who does not. The first thing I just really want to say is that especially the first part of this test is called the Beighton Score. A lot of people are going to pass the Beighton Score who do not have EDS. In fact, 20% of the population is hypermobile. So if you pass that, like, definitely do not get scared that you have EDS. And also, it's not going to be surprising that if you pass that, that you might also have some other features. The point is, do you pass all of it and do you also deal with like a whole bunch of issues, you know? So let's get to it.
Cool.
Okay, so the first part of this test is called the Beighton Score, and we both have to get 5 out of 9 points in order to pass it because we are under the age of 50 and we're not children. The first thing, does your pinky bend back greater than 90 degrees? That one's no.
That's a no.
Okay. It's hard for me to see. That's also a no. Okay, and then for me,
my fingers are really gross. So that one.
Definitely those. That's gross.
And then this one. It's funny because the pinky.
Okay, so I got 0 points.
Yeah, you got 0. I got 2. The next is, can your thumb touch your wrist? Okay, so the next one is, can you touch your thumb to your wrist, Renata? And you get 1 point for each hand.
Okay.
No.
How?
Just don't hurt yourself. Like, it's not supposed to hurt. Don't. No. Okay.
So you. Oh my god, that one's even worse.
Okay, so for me, I actually can do it, but because I have pretty bad wrist instability and sometimes they can really hurt and be hard for me to do it, I'm putting up a picture of me doing it on each hand. They're horrible faces, I know, but I get a point for each one. The next is, does your elbow hyperextend greater than 10 degrees? And you get 1 point for each arm.
I feel like I just have like a fat.
I think that's
see what
a
I
no.
Mean?
I think that's a no. You hyperextend a little bit. Wait, straighten it completely. Yeah, no. Next.
I just feel like my skin like hangs right here and it makes it look like.
Honestly, I can't really tell and I feel bad giving you a 0 because I almost. Oh, wait. No.
No, I don't think they do at all.
For me, mine hyperextend only a little bit, so they don't. This one does not pass. And let's see. Does this one pass? Probably not. It hyperextends a little bit, but I don't know. That one might pass, that one might not.
And the last thing is, can you touch the ground completely flat hands, keeping your legs straight?
Nice, you got 1 point.
Thank God.
Okay.
You know what I mean.
Okay, got it?
Yeah, that's good.
So Renata got 1 out of 9, potentially 2 out of 9. We couldn't really tell with that elbow. I have 5 out of 9 and potentially 6 out of 9. Also couldn't tell with one of my elbows if it was quite 10 degrees. Okay, so because I got 5 out of 9, I passed the whole first part of the criteria number one, but Renata didn't, so she has a secondary like portion that she's just gonna see if she passes. So you have to answer 2 out of 5 questions. Can you now or could you ever place your hands flat on the floor without bending your knees?
I just did that, yep. So yeah.
Can you now or could you ever bend your thumb to touch your forearm?
When I was younger, I could do it.
Okay. As a child, did you amuse your friends by contorting your body into strange shapes, or could you do the splits?
I did like the frontward split, not
the
straddle.
Yeah, not the straddle. As a child or teenager, did your shoulder or kneecap dislocate on more than one occasion?
No.
Yeah, not at all. And then do you consider yourself double jointed?
No.
So you do pass that part, so great, we can move on to the second part of the criteria. Yeah. So for criteria one, Renata got a yes, and I got a yes. So this is now part two, and there is part A, B, and C underneath part two. You have to pass 2 out of 3. So in A, there are 12 features, you need at least 5 of them. Okay, the first, do you have unusually soft or velvety skin?
It's soft, but I wouldn't say it's like unusually soft like yours.
Yeah, I think mine's like
way soft.
Yeah. So I say yes, hers is no. 1-0. Mild skin hypersensibility.
No, I do not have that at all.
Okay.
I already know that.
For me, I know that like I do. It's not
I can't do that.
Crazy, like, but I do have it. Yeah. For me, I didn't realize. These are sick. How much can you pull this stuff? Huh, interesting.
Oh my god.
I didn't know that this part was stretchy. I thought that
can
everybody.
I try?
Yeah.
Try mine.
I guess it doesn't like come off as much as mine does. Unexplained stria. I was referring to unexplained stretch marks that are not due to weight loss or weight gain. I do have straight stretch marks, but I don't. I don't know if it counts or not. They gave me out a bunch, but like, I don't know if it's like an unusual amount, so I can't really say.
I don't have any stretch marks.
Okay. I'm jealous.
Thanks, Mom.
Bilateral piezogenic papules of the heel.
Oh.
You do have this, don't you?
I have no idea what it is.
Oh, okay. I knew it was.
I was gonna make a joke.
What was the joke?
I'm gonna be like, oh, I love that.
Oh, yes. Very nice.
Now change weight on your heels and stuff. So yeah, you don't have any of these.
Ow. Oh, my bilateral. Recurrent or multiple abdominal hernias? No. Atrophic scarring at least two sites at the formation of truly peppery. Let me just say, do you have atrophic scarring? You don't, and I don't.
I don't know what it is.
You don't have atrophic scarring.
What is it?
I've seen everything that you have. It's like in depth. It's like in the
heels. Oh yeah, no, I did not have it.
I know. A lot of times, like, people tend to have like more like hypertrophic. For me, I don't really think I do, so no. This one is like long, but basically, I mean, I know your answer is no. Pelvic floor, rectal, or uterine prolapse.
Okay, no, I don't have that.
Okay, yeah, no, me either. Dental crowding and high or narrow palate. Let me see your mouth. Let me just see your mouth. Yeah, your palate looks normal. I don't freaking know what a normal palate is.
I had a palate expander.
Okay, like sometimes that happens with dental crowding. Look at me, I don't think
Does that mean you said your teeth look really like close together?
Kind of, or like yes, but I wouldn't know.
Don't look at my mouth. I mean, I don't even know what mine looks like.
My dentist told me that it was a little high. But,
High?
High. Maybe high or narrow. But.
Mine's just pretty normal.
I think mine's normal. I don't really know. I'm not gonna count it for me because I don't know what normal is.
I'm not gonna count
it
for me either.
Okay, arachnodactyly, which is defined by one or more of the following. So, positive Walker sign. I just get confused between Steinberg and Walker. Hold on. No, it has to overlap. I can't even freaking fit it. Okay.
That means you have EDS, you can do that?
No, it does not. That's a marfanoid habitus like feature. You know what that means, whatever. Now if you take this finger and like put it across your hand and does it pass it? No. And then for me. Oops. The thing is, I don't really have arachnodactyly, but I do pass. Probably just because of my thumb hypermobility, mm-hmm. But because I pass the sign, I pass for arachnodactyly. Next. Arms stand to height ratio of greater than 1.05. Okay, so you're about 61 and a half. Just put your arms as straight and as far as possible. And you are at 62. Okay, 63 and three quarters. And then for this?
65 and three
quarters. Okay, 65 and three quarters? Okay, so I just calculated our arm to height span ratio. Renata's is 1.008 and mine is 1.03, so neither of us passed for that. It's basically saying, are your arms longer than you are long height-wise? Don't you love my wording? It's
Luckily,
great.
Luckily, she's a smart one. Because I would have no idea how to do
You're
that.
You're smart too.
In different ways.
Mitral valve prolapse mild or greater based on strict echocardiographic criteria.
I don't think I have that.
Have you ever had an echo or ultrasound to your heart?
No.
So you don't even know, but no. And then for me, I don't. There is something weird with my mitral valve, but it's not a prolapse. It's just like long, strangely opened. I don't freaking know, but something weird, but no. And then lastly is aortic root dilation with a disease score greater than positive 2. No.
No.
No. Great. So Renata got 0 out of 12, and actually I'm really confused right now because I know when the doctor tested me I had 6 out of 12 because I had one more than like you needed to pass, like an extra one. So I think that means then, because I don't remember.
How was the dental crowding?
I don't know, maybe he looked at my palate because I know the dentist said I had high palate a little bit. And then also he also may have looked at my stretch marks and said that they were abnormal. I don't remember, but I'm just gonna put a 6 out of 12 because that's what I know was on my chart when he did it. And I don't know exactly which ones he did, but I know for a fact I got 4 out of 12 when I just did it with
him.
Feature B. Now you need a positive family history. So one or more first degree relatives independently meeting the criteria for hEDS.
I don't think any of my family members have been.
What's a first degree relative? Because actually my cousin a year ago, who's my age, got diagnosed with hypermobile EDS. So that's a yes or a no for me, I'm not sure. Who shares 50% of their genes? Yeah, no, that's not 50% of their genes.
Yeah,
so. Now C, this is the last big criteria. By the way, if you're still watching, we have a surprise at the end. Or not really, it's just a cool little announcement, so stick around. C So anyway, lastly, basically, you need to have at least one out of three of these. Musculoskeletal pain in two or more limbs reoccurring daily for at least 3 months. Yes.
Okay, does that mean my shoulder? But I also hurt my shoulder.
Is there any other?
I feel like I would know.
Yes. That's a no.
So no.
For me, that's
yes.
Chronic pain widespread from greater than 3 months.
I definitely have that.
Okay, so that's a yes for you, so then mm-hmm. you pass this. I pass it too, obviously. And then the last thing is reoccurrent joint dislocations or frank joint instability in the absence of trauma. Heck yes.
Yes, okay, obviously.
Wait, what?
For you.
Oh, I thought you were saying yes for you, and I was like, wait, what? I was like... Now, the last thing is criteria three, and you have to answer no to the following three questions. Now, I just want to quickly say that if you have EDS and you say yes to one of these questions, that doesn't mean you can't have EDS. But the point is that it's trying to take certain conditions out of the equation that can potentially be causing the same symptoms or similar symptoms and make you more likely to pass. Number one, absence of unusual skin fragility, which should prompt consideration of other types of EDS. No, mine's not particularly fragile.
I'm definitely not fragile.
Number two, exclusion of other heritable and acquired connective tissue disorders, including autoimmune rheumatological conditions. These are things like lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, or something else that would cause you some chronic pain and instability. No, for me, that's a no.
That's a no for me as well.
And then the last one is exclusion of alternative diagnoses that may also include joint hypermobility by means of things like hypotonia or connective tissue laxity. So these are things such as somebody who has another condition that causes severe weakness of your muscles. That'll make you more hypermobile and you actually might pass the criteria. It could also be something like you have Marfan syndrome. You may pass the criteria for EDS, but that does not mean you have EDS. It's instead Marfan syndrome that's allowing you to pass the criteria. For me, that's probably a no, but to be honest, we don't know what condition I actually have or what type of EDS I actually have because I've not been genetically tested yet.
I definitely also don't have that.
So that means that we passed this because we said no to all three. So now for the results. Basically, because there are three criteria, in order to pass this criteria, you have to say yes to basically all three. RENATA got a yes, then a no, then a yes. For me, I got a yes, then a yes, and then a yes. What an interesting thing about the criteria is that this section right here, the middle section, is really the part that's specific to EDS and other connective tissue disorders. So this is the most important category. Sometimes that would be like the first one, but really this is a very important category. Actually, all of them are important. I don't mean to be rude to the other criteria.
Sorry to hurt your feelings, I'm really sorry.
Something that's so important, and I really hope that you guys stuck around and listened to this, is that, you know, there's a lot more to this condition than these criteria. This criteria is not symptoms. This is criteria. So I have so many symptoms that are not even being slightly mentioned in here at all. And that really helps somebody decide if you have EDS or not. A doctor needs to do this. You cannot do this at home. And if you think that you may pass for this criteria, you need to see a doctor. Like, this is not, it's not a joke. It's not just hypermobility. Okay, last thing, RENATA just wants to tell you something.
So I'm a singer. I have a new song coming out on December 6th called Running With Knives. Izzy will put the link to my Spotify and my Apple Music in the bio. So I hope you guys get a chance to listen to it.
Yeah.
And I'd love for you to do that.
Okay, cool. Thanks guys so much for watching. Please let me know if you have any questions. Please don't get scared by this criteria at all. It's not what this is for. And I will see you guys on another video. Bye.
I left you on the camera.
Oh jeez, I'm scared.